Ava Max finally released her highly awaited debut studio album, Heaven and Hell. I'm going to cut to the chase and say the album is not bad, but it's not great. It doesn't really leave a distinct impression. Let's start with the album's production. The production is actually very nice. Sonically, it's dance pop that recalls a lot of 80s and 2010s pop. You can definitely hear hints of Madonna, Katy Perry, Britney Spears, and Lady Gaga within this album. All of those artists which she seems to be a direct product of, meaning you don't have to really search to find out her influences because it's quite obvious and blatant because she fails to extend their sound. Now, leading up to the release of her debut album, Miss Ava Max had a very ambitious mission statement, and that was, in her own words, to bring pop back. She had multiple delays with this album, a bit of a messy rollout, releasing tons of singles. A lot of them didn't make the cut, and it seemed that she was still trying to find the perfect sound for her album. Heaven and Hell is a pure commercial pop album. It doesn't really slow down at all, and when it does, it's still light over a slick electro pop beat. With that being said, it is also a generic pop album. But I would also like to mention, something being generic doesn't really default it to being bad. It just lacks personality. And it's not even just about the production. The lyrics are what really hold this album back. It's riddled with so many pop cliches that you've probably heard once, twice, or 20 times in your lifetime. Like the classic "what goes around comes around" trope, or "you're a misfit, but don't worry, I'm just like you" sentiment. Do you ever feel like a misfit? Everything inside you is dark and twisted, but it's okay to be different because baby, so am I. Those lyrics are a perfect example of some of the album's flimsy lyrics. Now, her diving into these subjects aren't a bad thing. These are subjects that will be recycled forever, but I will say her failure to do them in her own way leads them to its shortcomings. One thing that helps you look past those lyrics and helps them not sound so dated are the melodies. These are classic 2010s pop melodies. There's so many hooks in most of the songs, even though some of them tend to sound familiar. Not even just pertaining to 2010s pop artists, but some of them sound like they may be recycled from Ava herself. I feel like she might have felt pressured to achieve the same success that her biggest single, Sweet But Psycho, did, while obviously with another song. Songs like Kings and Queens, So Am I, and OMG What's Happening all have psycho-ism sprinkled throughout them. I also think the concept with Heaven and Hell on this album isn't well put together. Sure, the second half of the album is a little moodier, but I wouldn't say it differentiates much from the first half. I mean, she has So Am I on the Hell side of the album. That should explain it all. It also doesn't tell a story, even though the way this album is set up, it alludes to that. It's like she wanted this album to weave into a story or concept, but she never truly got to a fully cohesive or concise story. Basically, she doesn't stick the landing with the concept. Also feel like the lyricism was a little too vapid for a concept album anyways. Some people may think differently, but I feel like really good concept albums always have strong, personal, and really thoughtful lyricism. And the lyricism doesn't even have to be this great, mind-bending masterpiece. However, it also doesn't have to heavily rely on pop cliches. I think Ava has still yet to truly define who she is as an artist, but hopefully that can come in time for her. This album does have a few highlights though. I think the most notable being Naked, a song where she slows it down a little bit and talks about someone having to know the real her to obtain her heart. Tattoo is another song that stuck with me, an electro pop song where she talks about the mark she leaves on her lovers. Torn is a song that I think is amongst her best work ever. It's an abiding dance pop song where she's feeling conflicted about a relationship. Thematically, this album mostly consists of self-empowerment, love, and relationship problems as a center topic. All in all, this album is generic. It has a lot of pop cliches, but the production is nice and the melodies on this album are catchy, and it recalls a lot of the 2010s pop movement. I think there's a few earworms here that sound like radio hits. However, I'm still left to wonder who Ava Max is as an artist. This album offers a clear direction in which she's going, but it doesn't hit all its marks. Listening to this album, I will say I think Ava has room to grow, and she could definitely expand more with time. With all its flaws, I would still consider this a step in the right direction for her, because she finally got a body of work out after so many delays. Heaven and Hell gives more sweet on both ends of the album more than it gives psycho on the Hell side. For someone who said they wanted to bring pop back, she set her standards high. And maybe she'll reach that level where she becomes a pop superstar. but I don't think her debut album would be the attributing factor to get her there.